Ladies and gentlemen, our next speaker is Jeffrey Weingarten, Tea Party and grassroots organizer of NJTeaParty.com, a nonpartisan organization of conservative citizens. Ladies and gentlemen, please, let's give him a round of applause.
Hi, folks. I'd like to thank Irene and Adrian and Barry Silverman, who worked to put this wonderful event on, my fellow and sister speakers, and all of you for coming here. Thank you very much. We really lean to support the grassroots. I'd like to just mention one thing, and that is we're not necessarily nonpartisan, because our group believes that the way to get things done is actually help find, support, and help elect good people. Right. It was last February 19th, almost a year to the day ago, when Rick Santelli on Little Watch CNBC ranted to America that the administration was, and I quote, promoting bad behavior, and how about if we help those who might have a chance at carrying the water instead of drinking the water? And he was right, folks. America was founded on a tax revolt against the tyrannical government, and our present-day government has done much of the same things. They've pushed and passed tax legislation literally in the dark of night, written in foreign tongues, which those of us who aren't lawyers call legalese, that literally defies comprehension. They obfuscate the issues with multi-thousand page bills. They insult our intelligence. They propose things for the good of all of us, and yet they exempt themselves. This has to change. The Obama administration wants us to believe two basic premises: that they have tried to enact over the wishes and awareness of we the people. The first is the ridiculous notion that you can get out of debt simply by going deeper in debt. Folks, this is true. They want us to believe that eventually we can fill up a hole if only we just keep digging. Anybody who's overdrawn a bank account, anybody that has passed their credit limit on credit cards, knows the fallacy of this basic premise. And this is manifest in TARP, the stimulus, or as we call it, the porculus bill. Cash for clunkers, which certainly helped foreign car makers. Cap and trade, or as we also call it, cap or something close to that, tax. It just doesn't work. The second premise upon which this administration is founded is that the government is the solution for everything. The nanny state, if you will. I've often been asked, how do we join this movement? Well, the answer is simple. You need one of these magic cards. No, really, folks. That you join by becoming aware, simply becoming aware. Do your due diligence. Talk to people or your family, Fox News, where you'll see a number of our panel appearing regularly. I believe, indeed, we all must believe, that an informed electorate will make the right decisions. That's how our republic works. Just look at the incredible experiences we had in Virginia, in my own state of New Jersey, and most recently in Massachusetts. I trust all of our citizens to make the right, no pun intended, well, maybe a little, to make the right choices. But patriots, and you are all patriots, we are faced with a very critical situation. There are many among us, among the Tea Parties, among other conservative groups around the country, who can't wait to flex their and our newfound political muscle. Some clamor for their own party, a Tea Party. I have a 19-year-old son, and from our first Tea Party last April 15th, I told him that hopefully within my lifetime, and certainly with him, there will be a president elected from the Tea Party or whatever it will be called, but not now. We must be very careful not to split ourselves into two parties. Not. Other Tea Party leaders and other Tea Party goers and other conservative groups, not at this time, at least not before 2012 or until we recapture the presidency, whichever comes first.
Right.
It's tantamount to joining a circular firing squad. It's the Perot effect all over again, and will only serve to ensure continued democratic rule. We in New Jersey and the surrounding regions, we have five states that are members of NJTeaParty.com. We believe we found a viable way forward. Centered in New Jersey, many Tea Party and other conservative folks were not very keen, to say the least, about voting for Chris Christie. In fact, one of the more memorable quotes from the campaign was from former governor, and I say that proudly, former governor John Corzine. He said, and I quote, "I have the president coming to campaign for me. Who do they have? Joe Wilson?" Well, in fact, we did have Joe Wilson coming to us, along with four or five other great very well-known great conservative speakers attended and spoke at our Morristown pre-election Tea Party on November 1st and helped spread the word like wildfire around the state. And that word was, it is much better to vote for somebody who is closer and often alike in your beliefs than not vote for that person, thereby guaranteeing a victory of somebody, a Democrat, who is definitely against everything you believe.
Yes.
Shortly after that amazing victory, we realized that there were plenty of conservative folks spread all over the state and region. Months before the Scott heard round the world, we decided to see if we could coalesce these folks into some sort of actionable force, and we believe we've done so. From the middle of the state, we saw that within approximately a 100-mile radius, there are perhaps 10 congressional districts that we feel we can help flip from Democrat to Republican in 2008. Leaders, and we're growing. 25 leaders from Tea Parties, conservative and grassroots organizations, some of the most powerful bloggers, CEOs of small businesses, and political professionals, insiders, and pundits. All have agreed to work for the election of these congressmen that we have identified, who are not necessarily from within our own districts, but whom we have collectively vetted and whom we believe can win their individual races and take that word back to their groups. And now here's where we the people come into play. We need to rely on our desire for real change, real honesty and transparency and simplicity. We need all of you to roll up your sleeves, become activists, make phone calls from home, make phone calls from phone banks, call on your neighbors and family, make and hand out flyers, knock on doors, attend rallies, give up your time, your energy, and your money if you can, because the eyes of the world are on us and the Tea Parties, and we must choose our battles with care and intelligence, knowing